Now that we have classified the materials according to the values of mu r, or more specifically the value of chi, that is the susceptibility, let us start discussing them one by one. So we actually said that the materials are either diamagnetic or paramagnetic or ferromagnetic. Right? Now what happens? So we are currently focused on the diamagnetism. To understand the cause of it, let me tell you first of all Lenz's law. That is actually the subject matter of the next chapter. That we'll do there in a lot of detail, but it will be required here to understand why at all diamagnetism arises in the first place. Now what happens? Lenz's law is nothing but the kind of inertial law that the nature follows. Okay, for example, you push a crate. What happens? The frictional force starts opposing you. Okay? It starts opposing you. Similarly, if there is a loop carrying a current, fine. So, say it carries current like this. This side is towards you. Okay? The left is towards you. Fine? You get the point. This is towards you, and that is there. That is away from you. This is kind of, I don't know how I draw it. Okay, so let us say, so this is like this, this ring, where this is towards you, that is away, and the thing that is towards you, it has got a current that goes like that. So you have got a field in this direction. So it has got its own field from right to the left, right? So this is the direction of the field due to the coil. Okay. Now suddenly you decide to apply an external field onto it. So what happens? Suppose suddenly I switch on a field like this. Then what happens? This actually wants the field through it to remain what it was earlier. It does not want to change. Okay. So what happens? It opposes you. What you are trying to do? You are trying to force a field in this direction. This coil already had a field linking it in this direction. So what will it do? It will actually try to oppose you, nullify you. What will you do? This field, you will add your own field, so the strength of field in this direction will go down. Is it not? For the current scenario, the strength of the field that it links goes down. So it does not want that. So what does it do? It will increase the current in this direction. Okay, it will actually increase the current in this direction so that the field from right to left is maintained. Okay, the field is maintained, and that is very important. If you had, so what does it do? Field opposite to its own field. I'll tell you. Maybe it is fixed. I'll tell you. Field opposite to its own field, what happens? Makes the coil increase its own current. Increase its current. For a field opposite to its own field, field opposite to its own field makes the coil increase its current in the direction shown. So it will increase its current in the same direction. Okay. Now what if the same coil the same direction, what happens? Suddenly what you do, you apply your field in this direction. Okay, this was its B coil. Maybe you can say I'm talking about its own Okay. Now what happens? If you apply a field in this direction, this field actually aids. It supports the field that was already there and it increases, it will try to increase the field. That too is not acceptable by this coil. So what will it do? It will actually oppose it and it will decelerate in this direction, or it will try to push a current in this direction. In fact, that's how you will see generators work.
The next chapter we will study. But this is like fixed and the current is traveling and it's not even rotating and the magnetic...
Nothing is required. The moment you try to pump in some flux or oppose that flux, it will automatically retort. It's actually changing the... I did not deliberately introduce the concept of flux. Actually, it is trying to change the magnetic flux through it. Flux is what? B dot ds.
Quantum magnetic field lines.
That multiplied by the area. That, it's not only the field. It's the total flux.
Field lines.
It's not only the field. So, for example, if here, you would have sort of squeezed the coil and made its, say, radius less, then what will it do? If it was kept in this field and suddenly you wanted to reduce the area, what will it do? It'll generate its own current. And that'll be in the opposite direction. For example, it was not carrying any current and you suddenly squeeze the field, that the coil, that means you reduce its area, then what will it do? It will induce a current in this direction to have that field, the original field, the original flux that it was. So B is the same, and you suddenly reduce the area. So what will it do? It will try to generate its own field, because it cannot fight with you in case of area. It cannot fight against you for not reducing the area, right? So what it does? It generates its own current, and that I'll come later when I do that. And you will actually feel a force. The current will be in such a direction that you will feel a force. You will feel that your the squeezing of this is not possible. It's not letting you reduce the area. I'll show you that, but I do not want you to kind of get confused right now. So you just concentrate here. When we go to the lenses, I'll show that. So what happens is, if the field supports its own field, supports the coil's own field, the coil tries to reduce the current in to reduce the current in its original direction drawn in blue, that is equivalently it tries to push in the opposite direction. A deceleration in this direction is actually acceleration in the opposite direction. To push the current in the opposite direction, to oppose the external field. You understand that? So what happens, whatever you do, it will always oppose you. Do you see that? You try to push a field like that, it opposes you. You try to push a field like this, it opposes you. Okay? So you are always opposed. Lenz's law. Fine? It has got its roots in the conservation of energy, but actually, since that is not our subject matter, so I am not kind of trying to confuse you. Yes, but when we study Lenz's law in some detail and you come back to this, then you will understand far, far, far better. Fine. Now let us come to the diamagnetic material. Why did I do all this? A diamagnetic material is such. The diamagnetic material is such that it does not have any magnetic moment in its steady state, in its relaxed state. Okay? Why? Because it is made up of some atoms, and all the atoms have their own electrons moving around them, right? moving around the nucleus. Fine. Now what happens? The moment you put that material inside the solenoid, something like this or this happens. Why? Because some of them are rotating like that. So what I mean to say is that the magnetic moment of some of the atoms is opposed by the field, and some of them is supported by the field, favored by the field. The total magnetic moment is zero because they are all randomly oriented. So that is zero. And what happens due to this, due to sudden application of your magnetic field, what they do? They oppose you. So they, in this case, they oppose you. In this case also, they oppose you. So maybe you understand now what happens. There are like this, and there are some like that, and some like that. Okay? And you suddenly decide to press a magnetic field like this. So your magnetic field opposes some, supports some, is it not? Or maybe is at 90 degree to some. Okay, when you are at 90 degree, you will find you are not cutting any area, so they will not be affected. Okay, because the flux was zero. So the flux that they encompass is zero. Now what happens? All this will oppose you, because this is this case. Say maybe this also opposes you, because this is this case. Okay, so what happens? The net becomes less than what you would have expected it to be. You understand? The net becomes less than what you expected it to be. So I'll write, when an external field is applied, the electrons the electrons accelerate or decelerate . See if we have a current in this direction like this, it means electrons are moving in this direction, is it not? Opposite. Now what happens? So the moment you want a higher current in this direction, what does it mean? It means that the electron has to accelerate, its VD has to go up, then only you'll increase the current. Otherwise there is simply no other way. You understand? The electron has to accelerate in this case. Okay, the electrons, and here what happens? Electrons are going like that, and they do not want to support you, so they'll have to become slower. So I'm saying, when an external field is applied, the electrons accelerate here. So yahan pe aap, you can write that here, electrons accelerate. And here the electrons decelerate. So when an external field is applied, the electrons accelerate or decelerate depending on whether